His Excellency the Governor, Mr. VPS Badnaw, he asked me, he said, "General, is there a military literature festival anywhere in India or in the world?" So I told him, I said, "I'm not aware. There isn't any military literature festival anywhere." So he said, "Why can't we have it in Chandigarh?" I said, "Certainly, we can make an effort. But first, I must have the views of the Chief Minister of Punjab."
4 years ago, we started the Military Fest program in Punjab. Object being to teach our youngsters with regards to military affairs, whether there were wars with China, whether there were wars with Pakistan.
The Military Literature Festival Chandigarh has gone from strength to strength over the years, bringing together veterans, historians, strategists, economists, poets, artists, former spies, politicians, and even film stars from all over the world, with a focus that always remains the military, past, present, and future.
Military Literature Festival of Punjab is one of the most inspiring events which takes place in Punjab every year. And it is attended by veterans who have not only done this country proud, but who can inspire future generations.
The soul of the Military Literature Festival actually focuses around the warrior, his activities, his culture, his knowledge, and his understanding that since he is powerful, he must always help the weak.
And I see lots of people there who are buying things and new books coming out, which I've read maybe 40 years ago or 50 years ago when I was under training myself. And subsequently, further research has gone into it and new books emerged with different events. So we thought that this was something that, of course, keep everyone abreast with what's going on, and also for the newer generation to understand.
Punjab has drunk deep the chalice of courage from one end of the world to the other. Punjab has been and is a land of soldiers since times immemorial. This is the first edition which is going virtual to honor our veterans, also to inspire younger generations and generations to come to follow the footsteps of our brave veterans.
Like shotgun shooting, horse shows, polo, to photography, to bird watching, to adventure events like cross-country runs, cycling, off-road shows, Braveheart motorbike shows, vintage car rallies, and paragliding. But now, this time, it will be virtual launch with more national and international participation.
I'm very happy that the organizers, led by General Shepir, have done a great job. It's grown in leaps and bounds. And where we started off as a little lit fest has now become the talk of India. And we are the only military history festival that is existing in the country.
I'm sure younger generations will be inspired, and we will not only learn, but we will enjoy ourselves at the festival.
This year, since we are going to have it virtual, I would want lots of people to be virtually be connected to us in this Military Literature Festival.
Well, I'm sure that this year we'll have a great virtual content which is going to reach out to the far corners of the globe.
So look forward to meeting you all in this virtual Military Literature Festival from the 18th to the 20th.
The Raksha Mantri will be addressing the Military Literature Festival in company of His Excellency the Governor and the Honorable Chief Minister.
It's going to be our fourth one, and I not only wish it success, I'm going to be very much part of it. For me, it's something that I look forward to every year, and I hope so will you.